everybody, it's me, Penguin, and I'm here to make a sweet treat video. I had a community post and more people have voted on seeing a sweet treat. So that's what we're gonna do. And today we are gonna make Dolly Parton's favorite banana pudding cake. It is a delicious cake. You guys would have to make it and try it to see. Plus there's tons of variations and we'll talk about that as we're making the cake. So I'm gonna turn you around and we're gonna talk about the ingredients. Okay, this is one of these cakes that you would just absolutely have to make it and taste it to totally understand. If you like banana pudding, you will absolutely love this cake. Now, me and the chef, we were at Big Lots and we saw this cake mix. Normally I like to do homemade, but I will do some box cake mixes as you guys know. And we are a big Dolly Parton fan, as many people in the world are. So we saw this Southern style banana cake. And if I sound really loud, I'm sorry, it's because I'm kind of close to the camera. Anyway, so I was looking on the back of it and there was a recipe for this. Dolly's favorite banana pudding cake. So that is what we're gonna make. Not saying ours is gonna look like that, but that's what we're gonna make today. So for this, you're going to need one box of this. Now I will tell you, you don't have to use this specific cake mix. They sell banana supreme cake mixes. They sell just banana flavored cake mixes. You can use a vanilla. You can use whatever flavor you would want to for you and your family. You could even use a yellow cake mix and add some banana extract to it. You're gonna get the same flavor pretty much. It's all in how you make it. You're also gonna need 1 cup of milk, 1/2 cup of unsalted butter melted, 4 eggs, 1/3 cup of Duncan Hines creamy buttercream frosting. Now there is a Dolly Parton buttercream frosting out there, but I'm not doing that. And you can also do homemade if you wanna make it, because it's simple to make a homemade buttercream frosting. But I've got some Wilton's buttercream frosting, so I'm gonna be using this. You're also going to need 1 package of vanilla or banana instant pudding mix. So I have the banana because you know what? We're sticking with the banana theme. This is a 3.4 ounce, just a great value brand. I think it was 72 cents at Walmart. You're gonna need 1 cup of cold milk, 1 cup of cold heavy whipping cream, 1 large banana. I have 2 here, one for the cake, one for maybe decorating later, and some vanilla wafers. You can use any kind, but as usual, you can see we've got a theme going on here. Not sponsored, great value, great value, great value, because in today's world, you just have to save where you can, because everything is just getting so expensive. Anyway, and you're gonna want some cooking spray. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna get my butter melted and get myself situated, and we're gonna start making this yummy cake. Okay, you're also gonna want 2 8-inch round cake pans. So I cut some parchment paper circles to fit the bottom of these, and that's what I'm gonna bake my cake in. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna start with our Duncan Hines cake mix. And again, you can use any banana cake mix you want. We're gonna get this in here. Smells like banana already. And to this, we are going to add 1 cup of milk. This is something that would be great for 4th of July coming up. If you're having a 4th of July get together with your family, this would be something, because you're going to keep it in the refrigerator, so it'd be a nice cold chilled dessert to make. Does any of you have big plans for the 4th of July coming up? Okay, I have 1/2 cup of unsalted butter melted. Gonna stir that around, and I'm gonna dump that in here. Chef's really excited about this cake because he loves banana pudding stuff. Okay, and we're gonna add in 4 eggs. I'm gonna break them into this bowl first. I'll bring you back. Okay, sorry about that, guys. I had to get the beater for my mixer, and in here I have 4 eggs. Minus any shell. Again, you know me, Penguin in her shells, her messes, but hey, we're keeping it real, right? I'm only human, what can I say? So we're gonna get this mixed up. Okay, so we've got that all mixed up for a couple of minutes, and now I'm gonna go turn the oven on. Sorry about that, guys. I should have had that preheated already. Okay, and yes, I had to take a sip. This is a Mountain Dew Baja Blast Zero Sugar. Love, love, love that stuff. I like the Baja Gold. Unfortunately, the Baja Gold doesn't come in the zero sugar yet, but I'm hoping eventually it's going to. It's just not there yet. Okay, so we've got our cake mix all mixed up. I just beat it up for a couple of minutes. And we're gonna get it evenly distributed into our pans right here. Okay, there we have it. I've got it evenly put between 2 8-inch pans. I'm gonna get these in the oven at 350 degrees. And I'm gonna set my timer for about 20 minutes. It says between 24 and 28 minutes, but you know, every oven is different. So I'm gonna set mine for 20 and I'll check it then. So while this is in the oven, we're gonna start working on something else. Okay, so we've got our cakes in the oven. I have a toothpick here. So when my timer goes off, I'm gonna check them with the toothpick. You know the cakes are done when you insert a toothpick in the center and they come out clean. If you don't have a toothpick, you can use a knife or something like that to check to make sure that they're done. But we're also going to need some crushed up vanilla wafers. You guys can use the name brand vanilla wafers. I'm using the Great Value brand for this. It calls for about 18 vanilla wafers crushed up, but I'm going to crush some extra just so that I have some... Sorry, you guys can't see anything when I got a camera like this. To get this open real quick. Okay. I want some extra so that I'll have some for decorating afterwards. So all I'm gonna do is I have a baggie here and I'm gonna take me some vanilla wafers. I'm gonna put the recommended amount in first, which is gonna be the 18. I'd say I probably have about 30 vanilla wafers in here. So I'm just gonna seal this up. I'm gonna make sure I've got all my air out of it. And you know what I'm gonna do? You can do it in a food processor if you want to. You can throw them all in a food processor. I'm just gonna take my old rolling pin and I'm just gonna roll them and get them all crunched up. And you know you have to take one out of the bag and eat it too. Okay, there we go. That is our crushed up vanilla wafers. So we're just waiting on the cakes to get done. And when they get done, of course, they have to cool because we're gonna be putting pudding and stuff on them. So once the cakes are done, I'll show you what they look like. Then we'll let them cool and then we'll go on with our next step. Now you wanna make sure you keep your heavy whipping cream in the refrigerator until you're ready to use it because we want it to be good and cold. So I'll see you guys back here in just a few minutes. Okay, cakes are all done and out of the oven. It took me 25 minutes. So I'm not gonna put these on a cooling rack. I'm gonna let them cool in the pan just because sometimes when you put them on a cooling rack and then you go to pick them up, they wanna break. So I can just invert these when I'm ready. So I'm gonna let these cool and then we'll get started on the next. Okay, everybody, I'm back. I went ahead and inverted my first layer onto my plate. And we're gonna get ready to start our topping. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna get our pudding made. Okay, so I'm gonna see if I can do this without bumping the camera any. Again, I just have a banana cream pudding and pie filling mix from Walmart. And I'm gonna dump it in. Now normally when you're making your pudding, it calls for 2 cups of milk. We're only gonna be using one. Only 1 cup of milk. You can use 2% or whole, whichever you prefer. So we're gonna dump that into our bowl. Make sure we get it all out of there. Okay, and then to that we're gonna add 1 cup of cold milk. Now the reason I didn't use my food processor for crumbling up the vanilla wafers is why dirty a food processor and make extra work for yourself when you don't have to. Right, so okay, so in goes our 1 cup of cold milk. All right, let's set this off to the side. And all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mix this up. Just gonna stir it around real good in here. with my whisk. Now it's thickening up. We're gonna go ahead and move on to step number two. Okay, it calls for some thin sliced banana. So I'm gonna take one of my bananas and that's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna cut my banana up. Okay, now it called for 24 banana slices. So we have about 27 banana slices, but that's okay. We're not gonna worry about it. So I'm gonna get this pushed off to the side. We're gonna start assembling this cake. We only have one more step to do after this, and that's when we get our top layer put on and we start decorating it. So let me get the camera moved back here. Get our cake here. All right. So I have my offset spatula here. You can use a spoon, whatever you want to. We're just gonna take some of this nice thick pudding. We're gonna put it right on top of our first cake layer. Got that down. Now the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna come along and we're gonna put banana pieces all around the top of our pudding. Okay, I think that looks pretty good. What do you guys think? You guys think it looks okay? Whoops, banana overboard. Okay, let me get my hands washed. I'll be right back. Okay, wanted to clean up my mess a little bit and get some stuff out of my way. Now we're gonna take some of those crumbled up Nilla wafers that we crushed a while ago. And we wanna sprinkle that goodness all over our bananas and our pudding. If it gets on the plate, that's okay. We can clean that up. You can put parchment paper underneath your cake if you want to kind of, you know, keep it from being so messy when you're decorating it and stuff, but I just sweep it off. No big deal. That's a nice curls around here. Okay, I think that looks good. All right, now comes the time. Oh, I missed a little spot. We want everybody to have some love. There we go. Okay. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my other cake that I've got right here. I went ahead and took a knife and I went around the edges real close to the pan to make sure that I was able to break it free. And I'm just gonna lift it off right here. I'm gonna peel my parchment paper off. See if I can do this with the camera in front of me. And I'm gonna place this right on top of my cake and I'm gonna press down. Press down gently. Make sure it looks like it's on there even. Any bananas that might be squeezing out or trying to abandon ship, you can just push them back in there. Okay. All right. So now I'm going to go wash my hands and we're going to get ready to take it on the next step. Okay. So now I've got this bowl right here. What we want to do is we want to take 1 cup of heavy whipping cream. I'm going to take 1 cup of heavy whipping cream and we're going to beat it to stiff peaks. Now I know it's better to do it in a metal bowl, but I already have this one down, so this is the one I'm going to use. Okay. 1 cup of heavy whipping cream. clean my mess up out here. So I say you want to keep your heavy whipping cream in the refrigerator until it's good and cold. And I'm just going to beat this until we get some stiff peaks. Okay guys, I think that'll be about it. Just check it real quick. Make sure that we get a stiff peak. Yep, and we do. We have a stiff peak in there. Okay. So now what we want to do is the recipe says to take a third cup of your buttercream frosting and mix in with this. So again, I've got some Wilton's buttercream frosting. You can use Duncan Hines, Betty Crocker, whatever kind you want. And I'm just going to guesstimate about a third of a cup. We're going to dump it into our, bowl right here. And I'm going to mix this up. Now we're just going to mix this on low speed. Okay, just until it's all combined and fluffy. That's what you want. Okay. So now what we're going to do is we're going to come back to our cake and we're going to start icing it. Push this back out of the way. And I'm going to work on my sides first. If we need to make more, we can make more. If you have a turntable, now is a good time to bring your turntable out. You can just turn your cake as you're working on it. I have one, but since we've moved here a few years ago, I just never unpacked it. Now I'm not exactly sure where it's at. Our table that we had before had a built-in turntable. So we're just gonna go through and if you want to get fancy with it, you can grab out your Wilton's piping bag, make you some extra decoration on it. Anything you want to do. If you hear noise in the background, it's just the fur babies. They just came in from outside. They're all hyper today. They get that way sometimes. I'm gonna keep turning it. Anyway, I'm gonna keep the camera on and I'll fast forward this part, guys. Okay, we're just going to go through and kind of neaten it up a little bit. Now when you get done decorating it, however you want to decorate it, you want to put it in the refrigerator for about 15 minutes at least. Before you serve it. You can leave it in there as long as you want to, but at least about 15 minutes will be good. Cover up any spots you may see that you may have missed. I'm just gonna come along the top like this. Just tap, you guys can see. And you guys even see what I'm doing. Just gonna come along the top and just tap a little. Tap, tap. Okay. Now, I have these extra vanilla wafer crumbs. You guys saw me crushing them up. I'm just gonna come along the sides of my cake. And just put some. You don't wanna play around with it too much. You just want to tap and go. Just tap and move on. Okay, now I'm just going to take these that I have around the bottom. Pick them up. You can do this on a, if you're worried about making too much of a mess, put it on a cookie sheet or something. Put your whole plate on a cookie sheet. And then you can just do the same thing. You don't have to worry about making too big of a mess. Got a few more crumbs left here, so I'm just going to touch up some spots that looks a little bare. Okay. Now, let me go wash my hands and we'll be back. Okay, so I got all my crumbs around the side. I just took my little, I took this little pan and spatula, went around the edge of the plate and scraped all them off. So now I'm just going to do a wipe down of my plate, and then we're going to decorate the top. And since we're done, we're going to put it in the fridge. You guys, I am so sorry that I forgot to turn the, I thought the camera was on. All I did was go around and alternate banana, vanilla wafer, banana, vanilla wafer all around it. And then I sprinkled some of my crumbs left right there in the center, and I got one finishing touch. I had a little thing of cherries left, so we topped it with a cherry. Yes, we did. So this is our Dolly Parton's favorite banana pudding cake. And they do serve this at Dollywood. This is one of the things that Dollywood is kind of famous for. So I'm going to stick it in the refrigerator for at least 15 minutes, probably a little bit longer than that, because me and Chef still have to have dinner. And when we cut into it, we'll show you what it looks like. Hey everybody, and we're back. I'm the Penguin.
I'm the Chef.
And Chef's here, yes. He's cooled down. He's had his dinner. Are you rested up now, Chef?
No.
No? Would banana cake make you feel better?
No, now I'm too full to eat any cake.
Now he says he's too full to eat any cake.
I gotta eat some.
He has to eat some, he says.
I have to.
Okay. So I just want to give you guys a close-up here. Again.
What? If I don't eat it, who's going to eat it?
I'll eat it.
If I don't eat it, who's going to eat it?
Now, I wanted to let you guys know, if you're not going to be serving this anytime soon, you don't want to put your bananas on there because you don't want them turning brown, right? Nobody wants to serve a cake to somebody that's got the oxidized bananas on there or whatever. So save the banana pieces for last. You can save your vanilla wafers for last too if you want. So we're going to cut into this. I don't know how well this is going to go because the camera is right in front of me. So hopefully I can do this without making a big mess. We're going to leave the cherry there. I think we're going to, if Chef wants it, he can have it. So we're just going to cut into this. I didn't even get a knife, guys. I'm just using my spatula here, my cake spatula. We're gonna cut a nice big old honking piece.
If not me,
right
then
there.
If not now, then when?
Maybe Dolly Parton will come and eat it in the middle of the night.
Yeah, I know.
You never know. She might see this video and think, oh, they made my favorite cake. Okay, guys, let's do this without making a big old mess.
She's done it. It's only $5,000 a slice.
Oh my lordy. Would you look at that? Wasn't there a video on YouTube a long time ago where this guy kept saying, would you look at that? I'm gonna have to find that. If I can find it, I'll put it on our community tab. Alright guys. That is Dolly Parton's favorite Southern banana pudding cake. So, it just wouldn't be justice if we didn't try it. I'm gonna move this real quick so I can show you guys what the inside looks like. Can you see that? The layer of stuff in there? Oh, weak. If you had more time, which I had thought about it, I thought about cutting these layers in half right here and doing a four layer banana cream pudding cake. But I didn't. I just kept it the way it was because we were a little short on time. And so now we're going to taste it. Yes, we are. Chef can't be on camera at the moment. But is it good?
Tastes like bananas.
Tastes like bananas. I'm going to grab you guys a bite here in a second.
My
not polite to talk with your mouth full.
They can get their own.
Okay, everybody. Woo, open line. Take a bite. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Not the bite.
You got the pudding in the middle. Okay, guys. What would you give this, Chef? On a scale of 0 to 10.
11.
Chef would give it 11. I'd give it like a 99 only because I made it. I endured the heat. Yes, I did.
Good.
This is a very good cake. Again, just imagine this, right? They sell cherry chip cake mixes as well. Just say you take a yellow cake mix. That's going to be your cake mix right here. You make it the same way I did this one with the melted butter, the milk, and the eggs. You buy a box of Jell-O cheesecake flavored pudding. And you use that for your pudding layer in there. And then you get some cherry pie filling. Put you some cherry pie filling in there. And crumble you up some graham cracker crumbs. So then you're going to have like a cheesecake kind of cake. And then you can do the same thing with the outside. You can make some cheesecake whipped frosting, top it with some cherry pie filling, sprinkle you on some graham cracker crumbs, and chill it. I bet that'd be really good, wouldn't it?
Uh-huh.
Anyway.
Or you can make a cherry chip cake with peanut butter icing.
Yeah, that's my favorite. Cherry chip cake with peanut butter icing is my ultimate favorite. Last time I had one, Chef made me one for my birthday, and it was really super good. Woo! Again, if you guys can see those layers in there, that pudding layer, oh, with bananas and the vanilla wafer crumbs. Super, super good, guys. So, anyway, that's it. That's our sweet treat video. And won't be long till we'll be back with another one. Because we've got a lot of recipes and a lot of stuff coming up. So, we will see you guys really soon in the next video.
See you guys later.
Have a good week. Bye, guys.